I've been thinking about snowmen, specifically about Christmas decorations, because Christmas decorations are interesting to me. When kids draw, you know, their family, they draw a house that's a square and a triangle together, and then they draw the stick figure person. And if you ask a child to draw a snowman, they're going to draw it the same way every time. Three balls of snow, three white balls, with some branch sticks that curiously have hands and are mostly straight, and then a carrot for a nose. I mean, does this look like a nose to you? Not particularly. And then coal for eyes, and then buttons, and then typically a top hat, because we all saw that 1990s, or maybe it was even earlier than that. I think it's actually a 60s or 70s Christmas special, but I saw it in the 90s. What interests me about that is that this form has built up over time. Initially, what we were trying to do was sculpt a man out of snow, a snowman. You made an effigy, a representation of a person. But over time, we now make representations of the representation. And that's a very interesting thing. If I carve a snowman, what I would like to do is make it look like a thing. I will use snow as my sculpting medium, and I'll make a human-looking thing. My dad, who is insufferably creative, incredibly creative, when he made snowmen with us as a child, he would roll up three snowballs to get kind of a shape to work with, and then he got out his machete. And one year he made an obelisk, an Egyptian-style obelisk, and that was his snow sculpture. And then he carved a gateway through it so that we kids could crawl around and around in circles through the snow sculpture. My point about all this is that it is very easy to get stuck in forms where we imitate an imitation, when the real trick is to get to the root of the thing so that it's only one layer. So that rather than experiencing life in a Kodak moment and trying to make your life like a Kodak moment, you actually have the thing that the Kodak moment is supposed to represent, which is direct experience with the way things are. And so that is my point about snowmen and carrots for noses, which is an odd thing to me. If you're going to have a Kodak moment or just any sort of experience, or, I mean, get closer to the root and make a snowman, not a snowman. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and subscribe below, and comment about the most bizarre and awesome snowman that you've ever made. We'll see you next time.